Hey everybody, this is Brian again from PNB Homestead. Wanted to show you the solid bar LED array and the kale that I've been stealing while Paula was out of town at a family wedding. So, you know, I try to leave enough for her to where when she comes home she'll get to have a nice little salad. But since she's been gone, I've had three meals where I added into a protein like eggs and some pork. And one night we had some, I made some chicken sausage. But that was just added into my kale salads, and we still have enough on here to where we're gonna have a harvest that Paul and I are gonna get probably at least two meals out of this kale. And I was feeding myself off of this kale and the new growth off of this bed. So you can see I thinned it out. You can see there's a lot of cut leaves here. So I thinned this out pretty good to give the smaller leaves a chance to express themselves and get bigger growth. And I was feeding myself off of just these two beds this week, no other salad. And you know, I love this stuff, man. It makes your gut feel so good. I mean, if you got IBS and you know, you want to try to help get some stuff in there to try to get that probiotics going in your stomach, this stuff is great, along with, you know, drinking the kefir. And then I went and bought some goat's milk kefir this weekend. You know, shh, don't tell Paula, because you know, I'm only supposed to drink her kefir. But I saw this goat's milk kefir when I was out of town on a business trip, and I drank that while I was out of town. And I really like this stuff, so I'm trying to convince Paula that we got to find a local creamery or something that's going to be able to sell us some goat's milk to start doing that with her kefir or kefir. I don't know which one you would pronounce it, but you know, I really like that flavor that goat's milk gives it. So I'm hopefully we'll be able to get Paula's kefir production into that range. And I won't have to buy it at the store anymore, because that stuff at the store, I believe it was $7.99 a quart, so it's pretty expensive. But anyway, I'm rambling again. Sometimes I do that, as you guys know that have been watching me for a while. I'll go off on a tangent. But so the kale is doing really well, and that's kind of the update for this week. I can't wait till we get the rest of these tents cleared out with all the peppers, and I'll show you guys that in the next video update for the large tent. But we're going to be pumping up the kale production, and we're going to probably switch over to doing just kale for the whole summer and shut down doing the lettuce. That way we'll just have the high nutrient kales to go along with all of our garden vegetables like our tomatoes and the peppers and the eggplants we grow outdoors. All right, well, this has been Brian. Talk to you again. Bye.